recommending our back for a second workout with you. This time it's a full weight workout. And hopefully you saw my video from last week, which was a standing workout. It's about 15 minutes long, so if you want to this week, you could do that workout first and then do this one afterwards, which should bring it to about half an hour. This workout's on the floor, so you will need your mat for this one. And you'll need a towel or a pillow as well. And also a band. So if you have your own band, then use it. If you don't need something fancy, you could just use a belt or a scarf. But make sure you have something before you start, because it will help you for the hamstring stretch. So as I said, it doesn't need to be fancy, a band or a belt. A band, a belt, or a scarf is fine. Okay. We're going to start laying down onto the floor. So just take the time. Let your knees come down to begin with. Down onto your side. And then just lay down onto your back. Now, if you usually come to one of my classes and you need a towel underneath your head, place your towel underneath or a pillow, just to bring your head up a little bit higher. Ideally, you want your head in a position where you can see in front of you. Your chin hasn't dropped back, you're looking in front of you. If that's difficult to do, then just pop your head a little bit higher with something underneath. So I'm going to start feet hip width apart. Little gap in between the knees. We have hips, knees, and feet all pointing forwards. Soften the shoulders, and then just feel as though your spine is nice and long. Let's start with a pelvic tilt. So from here, to tilt your pelvis, so your lower back gently touches down to the floor, and then just go back to where you were. So you're going to tilt your pelvis, the lower back gently touches down to the mat, and then come back to where you were. Just notice the spine imprint into the floor. Now, as you do this movement, I want to notice whether you can feel your tummy muscles switching on. As you roll back into that imprint, gently drawing through your belly button. But can you make sure that your glute muscles aren't squeezing? And that's the tricky bit. So as you tilt, gently drawing through your belly button, try not to squeeze and wrinkle. And let's do just two more. And then just your last one. Okay, we're going to stop now so you feel like you're resting level. So we're not imprinting the spine, but could you stop somewhere where you feel like you're resting level at bone at the bottom of your spine, like felt when you were rolling? And you just have a natural curve underneath the lower back. Place your fingertips up into your hip bones, so we're pulled around to the front. Should find hip bones and then just bring two fingertips onto the inside of either side. Gently draw your belly button in order to feel as though your hip bones are coming slightly closer together, so we're connecting into our core. And before we start moving, we're going to visualize this exercise. Could you imagine that you're making one foot a bit lighter, but without making the other foot any heavier? So we're not moving, we're just thinking about it. And then just relax and forget about it. So let's do the other side. Could you make the other foot a little bit lighter, but without making the other side any heavier? Okay, let's do it once more either side, just in your own time. And just start to notice whether you can feel muscles switching on. I can feel muscles working into the back of my thighs, onto my inner thighs. You might feel something going on in your tummy, the lower back, shoulders, or nothing. At this time, the foot that you're imagining is lighter. Could you lift your heel, lift the toes, just slightly off the floor? So again, imagine to start, the foot becomes lighter, the heel lifts, and then the toes lift. It's only slight for now, and I want to still work on making sure that the other foot doesn't become any heavier. Could you also concentrate on making sure that your hips aren't rocking from side to side as they go still. Okay, we're going to do a couple more on either side. Harder option. Could you lift your elbows up off the floor? Could you keep yourself just as steady as you were a moment ago? Last one on each side. And just relax there. Okay, let's keep the feet still hip width apart, let both arms float towards the ceiling. Let your shoulder blades relax into the floor, your fingertips are pointing up into the about softening through the ribs. And if this feels okay, could you go into a double arm pull? This time, we'll bring both arms all the way down to the floor. So reach your way up and over. And then bring them down by your side. Reaching, stretching through the elbows. Let's do just two more. And then your last one. Making one foot lighter, leaning that foot away from the floor. This time, you stretch it away from you, and then bring it back again. The other side, so we lift the heel, lift the toes, stretch away. It's called a leg slide, but we're not quite touching the floor, just extending. So same as before, can you work on making sure the other foot doesn't become any heavier, and your pelvis doesn't wobble from side to side? We're trying to use our core muscles to stay long as the start. Now, if you're relatively new to Pilates, I want to stay with this. Level 2, harder option, arms with the air. Remember the arm pullover we were working on a moment ago. Think about drawing into the belly button and let one foot lift. As it goes away, could you send the opposite arm away? So we lift the foot first. Opposite arm to the leg. Now, can you work on still keeping your pelvis steady? There's no wobble from side to side. We're lengthening now diagonally across the body. Strengthen the arm, strengthen the leg. Could you do the same thing with our double arm pulling? Remember, the arms go all the way down by your sides. Let's do just one more on each leg. To a lower back stretch here. So bring one knee into the chest, if you can bring the other leg in, and then just a little rock from side to side, releasing the lower back. Let one leg come down first, and then let the other leg down. Okay, we're going to come over onto the side now. You'll need your towel for this one, or your pillow. I've forgotten my one. So what you'll want to do is bring one arm directly out in front, your towel will be down to the floor, just so your head doesn't drop down too low, so you're stacked up in line with your body, so your mind's a little bit lower. Other arms on top. You just need the knees up in front, and if you can see, you always want to tuck your feet behind, so your heels will be lying on your spine. Soften the shoulders. You're going to stretch this top arm, lift it away up towards the ceiling. Just stop when it points the ceiling and then come back down. So let's do that again. So reach that arm wide, then lift it to the ceiling. And then come back down again. Now I want to work on trying to keep your nose and your thumb in line with each other. So if you feel as though you can't turn your head this far, you don't need to. You're just going to go just that point. Can you do this exercise with your soft, with your shoulders nice and soft? You want to draw down away from the hip. And we also want to keep the hips stacked on top of each other so they don't drop back behind. Now, if you're somebody with osteoporosis or osteopenia, you're going to stay with this movement, so we don't go any further. Otherwise, you could go a little bit further behind you. And if you've got the space, go a little bit further. You want to try and again, keep your nose in front. Let's do two more. So hips are stacked, knees stay together. And then just your last one. Excellent. Okay. Just use your hands to push yourself up. We're going to swap over to the other side. So you might want to just roll over away or just move over to the other side. So same again. Stretching both arms away. We've got knees up in front. You look over your shoulder, heels are in line with the spine. Stop from the shoulders. Hopefully you've got something underneath your head. So you're going to lift up towards the ceiling and then come back down here. So reach, stretch your way to the top arm. Think about keeping this elbow long. And you're trying to keep your nose and your thumb in line with each other. As before, if someone with osteoporosis, osteopenia, you stay where you are. So you always want to keep mobility movement smaller. Otherwise, if that's not you and this feels okay, and this is to your own body, try and go a little bit further. That's one of the key things in class, is just to listen to your own body. If it feels okay, go further. If it doesn't, then keep it small, just be kind to your body. Okay, let's do two more. And then just do the last one. We're going to go into a hamstring stretch. So again, I've got a band, you might have one, otherwise a scarf or a belt is fine. Bring one knee into your chest, hook the band under. Elbows are down by your sides. Can you straighten that leg away? So try to lengthen the leg. It's easier when your leg's a little bit lower to get it straight. And then try and bring your leg towards you, hold there. Just working on relaxing into the stretch. There shouldn't be any shaking going on or bending at the knee. You should feel a nice pull just down through the back of the thigh. So slightly uncomfortable stretch. It shouldn't be painful though. Okay, let's take a breath in, ready. As you breathe out, bring that leg a little bit closer, hold. Be careful the knee doesn't bend. Carefully relax that leg or switch over to the other side. So elbows come down on your side, just straighten that leg away. And then slowly, just notice how far you can pull it in. So relaxing into the stretch, about breathing in through the nose, breathing out through the mouth. Take a breath in. As you breathe out, bring the leg a little bit further, hold again. And then just relax it down. Brilliant. We're going to go on to one more exercise for the shoulder bridge. Feet back to hip width, small gap in between knees. You might find this exercise a bit easy with your feet closer towards your body rather than further. Let's go back to that imprinting movement again where we started right at the beginning of the workout. So tilting through the pelvis, gently drawing through the belly button, and then come back to where you were. So imprinting spine, drawing through the belly button, and then just come back to where you were. Okay, this time we're going to tilt and hold there. Can you press right down through your feet? So I want to feel as though your glute muscles are switching on. I'm going to lift just a little bit. Back down. So imprint the spine, draw into the belly button, press through your feet so you want to actively switch on the glutes, lift a little, and then come down. Now if this feels okay, I want to go a little bit further, but only to about the waistband of your trousers. So it's that order we're looking for, imprint, drawing through belly button, pressing through the feet, pushing down through the toes and then heels equally. If this feels okay, go a little bit further. So let's pull this halfway up your back so your rib cage is still on the floor. Just notice what happens at your knees as you come down. Can you keep your knee caps so steady as you come down? That lets them wobble or drop out to the sides. Now again, if know, somebody that has osteoporosis, osteopenia, you're going to stay halfway, so we don't want to lift any higher up into the shoulder blades. If that's not you and the skill's okay, could you continue into a full shoulder bridge? Again, we want to work slowly down, even more so this one, so it's bone by bone, back and forth. So in crimp first, press through feet, feel the glutes working. Bone by bone, we'll lift into that point that you're working to. Just make sure that your head is still looking forward so that it's not, chin hasn't lifted up. We're going to do two more, harder option if you want to. Arms go across the chest. See if you can keep your knees very steady on the way back down. And then just your last one. Excellent. Okay, once you finish, full body stretch, stretching your arms away, stretching your legs away. Try and get yourself as long as tall as you can. And then just relaxing. We're going to roll over onto one side. Just take your time, push yourself up onto your knees. One leg comes up in front of you. You're going to press lift up to standing. Good. Your legs are going to shake out. Well done. We're going to go into another full body stretch and finish. So feet are hip width apart, you're standing tall. Take a breath in, lift up. Nice and tall up. Your arms breathe out as you come down. So breathing in as you lift up, out as you come back down. Last one, breath in to lift, and then breathing out. Excellent. Well done. That's workout two done. And if you're able to, hopefully you've done the workout with me and haven't just sat there and watched. You've done it once. Could you do it a second time this week? Maybe on its own or with the standing.